Want to speak real Spanish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at SpanishPod101.com.
Hello there, my friends from SpanishPod101.com. As you may know, my name is Diego.
And I'm Efraín.
And in today's video, we're going to cover a special verb in Spanish, and that's the verb ir. We're going to cover the conjugations, but also some special uses. So, enjoy this video. Woo! So, the verb ir is considered irregular, so it doesn't follow the conventional rules for conjugation.
Yeah, that's correct. So, the verb ir comes into play in many situations that are parallel to English uses. And so, in this video, we're just going to cover the basic conjugation of this verb. And also, we're going to give you some hints on the special usages of this verb. So, let's see the first one, the first conjugation.
So, the first way to conjugate the verb ir is presente del indicativo. And it is used for habits, okay? For example, yo voy a mi casa. Yo voy al gimnasio. Tú vas al gimnasio. Tú vas a la tienda, okay? Yo voy, tú vas, él, ella, usted va. Nosotros vamos, ellos, ellas van.
And ustedes van,
se me está.
I forgot that.
Now, remember this is especially important in this verb.
This verb needs a preposition because we're talking about going to a place. So we mean toward, and that preposition is a. So that's why we will say yo voy al gimnasio o voy a la tienda. So we always need this preposition. Now, the second conjugation of this verb is pretty irregular, and we're talking about the pretérito. Okay, so in the pretérito, the good news is that the conjugation of the verb ir is the same as the conjugation of the verb ser. It's kind of strange, but yeah, it is the same. So it will be yo fui, tú fuiste, él, ella, usted fue, nosotros fuimos, and ellos, ellas, ustedes fueron. Remember that we were talking about going to a place or towards somewhere, we're going to use this preposition a. So, for example, ayer fui a la tienda y me encontré a Marta.
Marta.
Yeah.
So, the other way to conjugate the verb ir is in the imperfecto.
Yeah.
So, the imperfecto is commonly used when you want to describe a past action or a fact that didn't have a definite end. That is, it can happen in the present. For example, yo iba a la escuela cada día. Diego y yo íbamos a la escuela todos los días. ¡Ahí nos conocimos!
Yeah.
¡Ay, perdón! So, yo iba. Tú ibas. Él, ella, usted iba. Nosotros íbamos. Ellos, ellas, ustedes iban.
Very good, very good. Now, the next one is the participio of the verb ir. And the participio, remember, that is used especially in the perfecto tenses. So that is, we can use it in the pretérito perfecto, okay? Mm-hmm. Or in the pluscuamperfecto even. And the participio is just ido, okay? So, for example, yo he ido. Efraín, esta semana yo he ido al cine 5 veces.
¿Con Marta?
No, con Lucía. Oh. tú has ido, él ha ido, so you see it's the same. Nosotros hemos ido, ellos, ellas, ustedes han ido. And the pluscuamperfecto as well, so había ido. Oh, Efraín, ayer fui a un parque de diversiones. Hace mucho que no había ido a un parque de diversiones.
¡Qué bonito!
Yeah, muy bonito.
So, the next one is the futuro indicativo, and it has the same root of the verb, ir. So you use it to describe an action that is going to happen, okay? For example, mañana iré a ver a mi asesora de tesis. No me he titulado. Él sí.
Sí. Okay. So, okay. Well, the next one is that you can use the subjuntivo. And yeah, we know that the subjuntivo sometimes is a headache. We know it. But, well, we're going to cover very quickly the subjuntivo presente and subjuntivo pasado. So, in the subjuntivo presente, it is really, really, really irregular, the verb ir. And we can use it with quizás. Okay? So, quizás plus the subjuntivo. And the subjuntivo is vaya, yo, vaya, quizás yo vaya, or tú, quizás tú vayas, quizás él, ella, usted vaya, quizás nosotros vayamos, o quizás ellos, ellas, ustedes vayan. Okay, so that's for the subjuntivo presente. So the next one is when we use the imperfecto, the subjuntivo in the past, okay? So, for example, for this we can use no esperaba que, okay? No esperaba que yo fuera, no esperaba que tú fueras, no esperaba que él, ella, usted fuera, no esperaba que nosotros fuéramos, no esperábamos que nosotros fuéramos a trabajar para SpanishPod101.com.
Wow!
Yes! Super cool! Or no esperaba que ellos, ellas, ustedes fueran. So you see, this is like the basic conjugation of the verb ir. Now we're going to cover some special usages of this verb.
One of the special usages of the verb ir is when you want to give a warning, okay? And remember that for a warning, you use the subjuntivo.
Yeah.
That we explained before. So, for example, when you want to say, don't go get yourself in trouble, you say, no te vayas a meter en problemas. For this situation, which is raining, don't go get yourself wet.
Yeah.
No te vayas a mojar, Diego.
No.
Está lloviendo.
No, no voy a salir. No voy a salir.
Okay. When you want to give a warning to your friend, for example, this. Diego, no le vayas a decir a nadie mi secreto.
No. Tu secreto está a salvo conmigo.
Don't you tell my secret to anybody.
Yeah, that's correct. Good. Now, also, the verb ir is very handy when you want to talk about the future. Now, we do have a tense for the future that you need to know how to conjugate in each verb. But also, you can use the verb ir to mean the future. Mm-hmm. So, it's like in English when you say, I'm going to. It's the same in Spanish. So, it's voy a. So, for example, Efraín... Ya tengo que irme, pero no te preocupes, voy a llamarte cuando llegue a mi casa, ¿ok?
Sí.
Sí. Or, for example.
Sí, por favor.
¿Qué vas a hacer mañana? Or, we can also, it's very handy when we want to speak about the past. It's once again, as in English, I was going to, ¿ok? So, for example. Efraín, vi un curso de alemán y me iba a inscribir, pero ya no puedo por tanto trabajo que tengo ahora.
So, the next special use is vamos a, which means let's. For example, vamos al cine. Let's go to the cinema. Vamos a comer tacos. Vamos a...
bailar.
Vamos a bailar.
Okay, so the next special use is with the verb ir and when we put a preposition. Yeah. So when we have the preposition por, ir por means go get something. Okay, like, Efraín, tenemos que irnos, deja, voy por las llaves. Okay, I'll go get the keys. Mm-hmm. Okay, but also we have the special use of irle a. And irle a is like when you say in English to root for. Like, for example, a candidate in a political party or even a team. Okay? So, for example, yo en México, yo le voy a los Pumas. Yeah, that's my team.
Congratulations.
Okay, the next one is vaya by itself, which means all right. Yeah. Okay?
For example, I forgot, me olvidé de quitarme mi chamarra antes de grabar otra vez.
Vaya.
Another example. Digo, ¿cuántos tacos te comes en una noche?
Si tengo mucha hambre, 15.
15? Vaya. Yo me como solamente 4. Y sin salsa. Bueno, con poquita salsa para que pique.
Now, finally, with vaya, when you use vaya plus a noun, it is the same as in English when you say what a, okay? So, for example, vaya plomero. Vaya plomero. Vaya plomero, no arregló muy bien mis tuberías y ahora tengo una gotera aquí arriba.
So that's it for today, my friends of SpanishPod101.com. If you liked this video, give us your thumbs up and write your comments and share it with our learners. What else? I don't know. Anyway, thank you for watching us. See you in our next video. Hasta luego.
Bye bye.